Hello friends. Some time ago, I reviewed a power supply that can operate both from the mains and from a battery, providing instant switching in case of a power outage. The topic seemed interesting to me, and in this video, I will talk about a similar device, only with higher power, 350 watts, and with a higher battery charging current, up to 5 amps in the 12-volt version, which I find more important and significant. In addition, I will show a solution to the problem of voltage spikes that occur when switching power from the mains to the battery and back, allowing you to regulate it over a fairly wide range, using one power supply for devices with different operating voltages. Before we start, as usual, I ask you to like this video, as it will help others interested in this topic find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. The device comes in a simple cardboard box with a cutout indicating the output voltage, since there is also a 24-volt version. Compared to the power supply I reviewed earlier, for those who haven't seen it, link in the description, the one feature in this review is significantly more compact, despite being more powerful. This compactness is due to the presence of a fan for force cooling, which the previous device lacked, hence the need to make it larger and include perforation in the case. Besides the power supply itself, nothing else was included in the package. The maximum rated output current is 20 amps, which is around 350 watts. However, it's important to understand that this also depends on the connected battery, which must also be capable of delivering such a current. The battery charging current itself is up to 5 amps. On one side, there is a terminal block with 7 screw connections, input phase, neutral, and ground, output for the load, and battery connection. Before turning it on, make sure that the input voltage switch, located on the side, is set according to your mains voltage. In my case, it's 230 volts. As for the fan, it doesn't run constantly. Under light loads, for example, when powering a router or smart home server, it will be off most of the time. It will turn on periodically and then turn off. However, when it's running, it's quite loud, so using it in a room where someone is sleeping is probably not an option. The power supply is fairly easy to disassemble. Just a few screws on the sides need to be removed. The fan is attached to the top cover. It's a two-wire model rated for 12 volts. If desired, you can look for a quieter model of the same size. The assembly is neat, and I didn't notice any visible flaws. There's a 30-amp relay on the output for disconnecting the battery. When the discharge voltage is reached, for this model, it's between 9.5 and 10.3 volts. All components that heat up during operation are placed near the walls of the case and secured with screws, so the metal case serves as a heat sink. Overall, the impressions are positive. Everything is well made and of good quality, a good Chinese factory assembly. Let's start the test with adjusting the output voltage, which is done using the trimmer resistor on the left. The maximum is 14.92 volts. The minimum is 10.61 volts. I'll leave the voltage as it was by default, 13.6 volts. Next, we'll take a similar measurement for the battery output. The battery is not connected yet. The power supply's own consumption is about 3 watts. The voltage matches what I set for the load output. As we can see, everything is synchronized with the output. The 13.6 volts is set based on 3.4 volts per cell of the lithium iron phosphate battery I plan to use here. With the battery still not connected, the power consumption of the unit is 3 watts. When I connect the battery, the consumption increases to 60 watts. The battery is about 20 to 25% charged. It then drops slightly, but remains around 4 amps for the battery. During the tests, and I'll show this later, the maximum I observed was over 70 watts going to the battery, which aligns with the specified parameters. By the way, you can find the review of this battery in the description as well. Both mains power and battery are currently disconnected. When I turn it on, the output voltage appears and the light starts working. The voltage is what I set with the potentiometer, and the total power is 8 watts. I turn it off. The battery is not connected, so the light goes out. I turn it on again. Then connect the battery. The power increases as it starts charging. I turn off the mains power, and the light continues to work, now powered by the battery. The voltage is slightly lower as the battery is not fully charged yet. Turning the power back on increases the voltage, and the charging resumes. The output power for the load remains constant without interruptions. If you disconnect the battery, the light will only work from the mains. If you connect the battery while the power supply is disconnected from the mains, the load won't turn on. You need to turn it on from the mains at least once. Now, testing under load. The power supply is disconnected from the mains. The standard load current for this battery is up to 6 amps, which I've set on the test bench. The voltage drops to 12.5 volts, which is normal. I'll raise it to 12 amps, which is the maximum current for this battery. The power supply still has a lot of capacity left, but I can't increase the current any further. Let's connect the mains power. The power is now 168 watts, which includes both battery charging and load power. This is where the extra power capacity comes in handy. I disconnect the load. This is now the power supply's consumption and battery charging. By the way, it's even more than 5 amps now. I reconnect the load, and the battery continues to charge. A key feature of such power supplies is that when switching from mains power to battery and back, voltage spikes can occur. These spikes can range from a few tenths to several volts. However, this problem can be solved. To address this, I decided to use a converter like this one. It works for both boosting and lowering the voltage. You can input between 5 and 30 volts and get an output of 1.25 to 30 volts. With a maximum current of up to 8 amps, but with a power limit of no more than 100 watts. With this device, you can solve several issues at once, stabilizing the voltage to eliminate spikes during switching, smooth voltage adjustment, and simultaneously powering multiple devices with different voltages, if you connect several such converters. I'll leave a link to it in the video description. The output voltage of the power supply is nearly 13.6 volts. The converter output is 12.39 volts. When I disconnect the mains power, the voltage drops by 0.4 volts, but the output from the converter remains the same. Reconnecting the mains power, the converter continues to maintain the set value. The potentiometer marked as CV adjusts the voltage. Let's first check the minimum. Here we have 5 volts, suitable for powering USB devices. You just need to buy the appropriate connector or connect the cable directly. The voltage is stabilized and doesn't change when switching between the battery and the mains. The lower limit is 1.2 volts. It doesn't go lower than that. Now for the maximum. I reached almost 20 volts, it doesn't go higher. For 30 volts, a higher input voltage is needed. Here's another commonly used voltage, 19 volts. Testing under load. The converter is set to 12 volts, and the power supply output is nearly 13.6 volts. Switching to battery power, the output voltage of the converter remains unchanged. I increase the load current to 5 amps. There's only a slight drop on the converter. If needed, this can be easily corrected by setting the desired voltage with the load already connected. Currently, the voltage spike on the power supply output when switching from battery power is about 1 volt. On the converter output, nothing changes. This method is fully effective. This is another option for an uninterruptible DC power supply. Powerful enough to run a router, smart home server, IP cameras, backup lighting, and so on. The advantages include a fairly high battery charging current, which, based on the tests, can even slightly exceed 5 amps, a compact size, good build quality, and adjustable output voltage for using different batteries. The drawbacks include the noisy fan, although it doesn't run all the time, and the voltage spikes when switching between the mains and battery. A small and inexpensive upgrade allows you to stabilize the voltage, change it within a fairly wide range, and if you use multiple converters, provide autonomous power for devices with different input voltages. That's all for now. I hope this video was useful and interesting to you. I would appreciate your likes, as they help with YouTube promotion. If you don't want to miss new reviews and tutorials, subscribe to my channel. In the description, you'll find links to the stores where you can purchase the devices featured in the review, other videos on this topic, as well as links to my Telegram channel, Facebook page, and a group for discussions on smart home topics. Join us. It's going to be interesting. Thank you for watching. See you next time, and peace to all.